All right, welcome. We got news today and a Frosthaven update regarding information from Envelope X from Gloomhaven, and huge spoilers. So if you don't know anything about Envelope X or you don't know what's inside of it yet, you should not watch this stream because there's going to be spoilers here, unless you don't care about spoilers. But Cephalofair has generally been very strict about not wanting people to talk about this until they've experienced it for themselves. And you know, I haven't actually unlocked it in my campaign yet, but I was sort of forced to figure out what was in there, unfortunately. But you know, we'll unlock it eventually. I haven't actually played with you know, with what's in the envelope yet. But as many of you know, I am in the middle of updating some things for Frosthaven. So again, full spoilers from this point on. So leave if you don't want to know what's in Envelope X. So for those who do want to know, or who already know, Envelope X leads to unlocking a secret character class. And today, as part of the Frosthaven Kickstarter, they had an additional add-on where you could get physical components to go with Envelope X. When I backed the Kickstarter, I knew that I would want something like that. I didn't know it was inside of it, but now that I know, I'm happy that I did. So apparently that's going to be shipping with Frosthaven. But the components inside, I think, are like the mini, the mat, things like that. Well, to go along with that, we got news today that they recently done a refresh on that class to sort of update it and tweak some of the mechanics and some of the cards that are in there. And so what I was going to start doing tonight was start converting those cards over to Frosthaven format. So you'll be able to see what it looks like if you were to start from scratch with a new class. So that's what I'm going to work on. I'll try to keep an eye on chat. So if anyone has any questions on anything I'm doing, feel free to ask away. If you want to just talk Gloomhaven or anything else in general, feel free. And otherwise, I'm just going to kind of talk as I work. Here's the folder I keep everything in, so I'm going to start my new folder here. Have my templates. So if you go to Cephalofair's site, there's a link to download some files. And it has a PDF with all of the new assets for the new cards and everything. I'm going to save this. Also have the art for the card from here. Also just getting over COVID, so I'm gonna do my best to mute myself before I cough at times, but if I fail to, I apologize. All right. So I actually want to see if there's things like off of this PDF. There is, all right. Some art here, but I might actually have better luck getting the art from some of the other files. Stuff on here. Alright, other than the icon and class color, I think that's about all I need. I usually start with the mat and start with the class icon. Don't have a great image of the class icon, but I should be able to pull it at pretty high quality with this, so. Thank you. Let's get some color on here. We do have trait names. They were provided on the map. So we have armored, intimidating, and nimble. These mats are made. This text is actually a little bit lighter color than the actual class color. So to match the rest of the stuff in my template, I always like to pull from this. Intentionally did that XP one separately because I didn't want the one in the center of the XP icon to get colored. So I don't know what we're gonna put on the mat yet. Off of the PDF there. Sometimes with this, I end up actually going into Illustrator to be able to pull out some stuff. But this should be a straight image somewhere in here. Probably that. I'm gonna see if I can get a higher res image for that at some point, but for now, I think this will be alright. That's a good start. Front. Let's look at the back now. Usually at the back, we have a much more zoomed in picture. Not too much. I'll revisit complexity and all these other things afterwards, but that's gonna be about it for the mat. I'll fill in this after as well. Hey, Michael. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Alright. Good start for the map. Let's get the card back too while we're at it. Now the cards, the fun part. Thanks, Dunya. Alright, there's the colors. Yeah, so now that this has been updated, I think a lot of people are going to be wanting to playtest the new version, so I want to get this updated to Frosthaven version as soon as I can. Alright, I think that's about it for starting point. So now what I like to do, basically run down the cards and get me my starting point for each card. So I'm going to take this and move this off to my other monitor. And I'm just going to make each one of these will sort of represent a card. I'm going to name it after each card. I'll plug in the initiative, and then from there, it makes it easier for me as I'm sort of getting in a rhythm and actually adding in the abilities for each card. So Forgot to actually update the hand size on the map. Eleven card hand size. I have a few macros and things built in here too that help me copy and paste layer styles and shape styles and centering different item or layer groups. So if you see things moving around, you're not really sure why, that's the reason for it. So what I'm going to do with this, because this is a summon, I don't know, there's a few ways I can do this, but sometimes it's easier if I go through and make all the summons at once. So all three of these level 1 summons look like they're going to need a good amount of space for their abilities. So let me go grab summon frames with big box. Update these all in my template now. I made a couple copies of that. Yeah, no, I'm just edit those. At least for the level 1, I like to set the level 1 first, just so I don't have to keep doing it over and over again. I'll usually do it for X, but after that I'll just make a whole bunch of copies of X and then update them as I go through. 3 X's, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That should be all my ability cards that I need for rest. And keep an extra one just in case I need to redo something for any reason. This one has a summon on the bottom. I'll go back and do that after. Only one of them here right now. Nope, that's not right. This is just dummy text from one of the enemies that I created with it before. I can add in, you know, the pips and things for enhancements and whatnot. Those are in here. This class doesn't have it, but... Oh, I forgot I have the bottom. Yeah. So I can turn the pips on if I need to. Let me go back and add that other one. Armed and Dangerous. I love it. There was some talk about this on the Reddit post where apparently they didn't think Isaac was going to let that name stand, but he did. So I'm happy he did. That is quite funny. Interesting. Custom class that has a glow mechanic, and I feel like it has to have a card name with the same name. So I'm curious if that's true. Getting there. I need a coffee or something. Alright, so all my cards are set up now. Next thing I'll probably do is go in and fill in the summon art. Thank you. You know, they're actually zoomed in a bit more on the actual cards. I probably should too. I'm gonna have to go back and update the mat to include the flying icon, because some of these summons have that. Three bloat maggots. That sounds lovely. Can I not pull? This was. I didn't even realize what that was. Teleport for level 4, huh? You are very likely right. Seeing anything with teleport at level 4. I don't know if you're referring to the old version or if you're looking at the newer version of the card. I just assumed that there was no teleport because teleport came out with Forgotten Circles, and you know, that might have been a bad assumption, but do you know what card it is? Thanks, Sahil. It's I hope I pronounced that name right. It's just a fun hobby. I love the game, and it's a nice little creative outlet to mess around with this stuff, and it helps me get better at Photoshop and stuff too, so. Win-win. Also selfish because I like the new card formats, so I want to be able to use them. Thank you. Rage Hornets. And we are down to our last summon. That's my setup. So next thing I'll end up doing is going through and starting to make ability cards. So I've shown that on some of my other live streams. I'm going to end the stream here, but I am going to try to knock out at least a couple of cards to get started here. Level 2, Overwhelming Offensive, the teleport. Let me just double check that. It does. Yeah, what was the other class I had all four? Probably Beast. Nope. Beast Tyrant didn't have Fly. Must have been somewhere. Yeah, I'll end up lifting this because I had to build one that had all four of them on it. So let me do that. Good catch. Thank you for that. Oh, hey, Dareth. Try to get my capitalization correct here. Oh, it's awesome to hear that you're using them. Are you using them in person or on Tabletop Simulator? One card before I end the stream. A bit of a tight fit, but gives 2 XP. Frames it here. Yeah, that's another thing I have to go through and do with each new class is set the all the colors and all the different frames and everything. Looks like it's all set. And the bottom. Need an action with a bubble. Actually need two of them. Need a divider. Need the wound icon big. Expresso leeches say X or wear X. Cards like Death Watch. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, for summons, at least last time I had it for Mind Thief, we just did X. I think that's the standard syntax for summons. Good catch, though. I might be wrong. If I am, I'll end up having to go back and fix it. All right, I think that card's done. Plus one for each token on this card. Let me check that out. I think because that has a base attack, it's a little bit different. Interesting. Just because it might be confusing if it went from X to like zero. I think I'm going to keep it the way it is there. All right. Alright, I think that's going to be it for now. I'm going to toss these in the room with the start, and I'll probably knock a couple more cards out, but I'm going to hit the bed soon. But I'll work on this some more this weekend. Maybe I can knock it out before end of day Sunday. Hoping I don't lose power tomorrow. I'm in the Northeast, so we're about to get hit with like 2, maybe 3 feet of snow, so I have a generator, but we'll see what happens. Thanks everyone for watching, if you watched, and if you like this stuff, hit subscribe. I do a mix of some live streaming when I'm working on this, but I also put together sort of, you know, videos that cover other different topics. And I do both tabletop simulator and in-person gaming. So I do 3D printing and minis and all that stuff too. So.